Well, hello and welcome to the Operation Write Home Finish Strong blog hop for the Finish Strong campaign. We are going to be closing our doors and you need to get your cards in by August 1st. That's the last day we'll receive cards. After that, they will be returned to you at your cost. So we need you to make sure you get your cards mailed in during July so that they'll get here by August 1st. So we are going to do a start to finish card today. I'm going to show you the clean color pens that have been the latest rage. And I'm going to show you a house mouse stamp. It's a little red, white, and blue one since we're doing a red, white, and blue theme. And I wanted to give you a tip on cleaning your stamps. This is what I use for mine, a stamp scrubber. And especially when I change from using Memento ink for my Copics to archival or VersaFine for watercolor, I want to get all the other ink off, especially with this. I'm using this ultra clear cleaner with my stamp scrubber, and I can really get all of that Copic friendly ink off because that stuff reacts with water and I don't want any black kind of mushing around in my watercolor. So then I'm going to stamp in the archival jet black ink for my watercoloring. I'm turning my stamp a little sideways because I want that pole to go all the way down the card. I'm going to have to extend it when I do my coloring, but I wanted to get that relatively straight on the card. Here's the clean color pens. They come in 80 colors, but the cool thing is they have a brush nib on the end, which means you can get some thick, thin stuff. You can get some, just the things that you can do with a brush that you can't really do with a foam nib on a marker. You can do with these. These are not refillable, and they come in about 80 colors, I believe. And I'm using specifically the 12 marker set because I want to show you, you can just have a couple markers and come out with some stuff that's really amazing. I have more videos on my other channel, so you're welcome to go subscribe over there as well. You'll see me along on the blog hop and be able to check out more of my videos there. So here I'm just adding water on top of this gray. I decided to do the gray stripe shadows before doing the red stripes because I wanted to follow along the little dots that they have in the stamp, and I wanted to not get red all over them. So while that dries, while the gray dries after having been activated with the water and it's all smooth and beautiful, I'm going to move on to doing the mouse. And all I had to do was scribble a little bit of brown, and then I can move it around really easily with a brush with just clean water on it. You can do the block technique, so scribble on a piece of plastic or on an acrylic block and pick up color to paint with, but you can also just color directly on it. And here you can see with this dark brown color, I have a flesh tone just by having a lot more water and less of the ink color. I can go back in and put more of the ink down and smoosh it around a little bit more. These are really malleable, and the instant you touch them with water, these inks react. So that's going to come into play a little bit later in this card. You're going to see some goof-ups that I made and some repair work that had to be done. But you can see you can create a flesh tone out of this. You don't need to buy a separate flesh tone. But the red color I'm going to show you, when you activate the red color, it goes really pink, really electric pink with water. And it's going to start making our flag look a little bit too pink if we don't put enough of the red marker down. So I'm going to leave just a few of the highlight areas as the watercolor, and the rest of it is going to be marker color because I don't want to look like we have suddenly changed the flag colors for the United States. So here you can see the pink really visually showing up, but it still looks okay because I've got enough red in there that they do look like red stripes. Next, I want to add the pole for the flag, so I'm just going to color a line straight down just so I kind of reserve that place. I'm not going to put my black lines down there until I get to the end because that'll make it a whole lot easier. And I should have done my clouds first, and you'll see why as I move on with this too, because if you do lighter colors, you can, you know, kind of color over things and then add more color on top. So any of these areas where I'm going to be struggling with stopping the blue color, I could have just gone right over top of it if I had done the clouds first. So as I work with these markers, I'm discovering things about them that, you know, I should probably do my, just make sure I work from my lightest to my darkest and be able to blend these colors better. But you can see how quickly water activates them. And I'm just going to use a lot of water to blend it out practically into white. And as I'm moving along here, you'll be able to see the butt, I call it the butt end, I'm not sure what it's called, but the tip end of my brush is the one that I get the detail out of. So that's what I'm pointing down toward the cloud that I'm working on. But the butt end is the end that's closer to my hand. That leaned down into that red area, and I dragged some pink out into my cloud. So I'm going to need to do a little repair. So I'll add a little bit of water, just enough to try to just wet some of that pink part so it will kind of start coming back up a little bit, and dab it up with a paper towel. And then in a little bit, I'll go back over it with a little more blue so it's a little less noticeable. And from here on, I'll be very, very careful, and I want to make sure I don't touch any of that brown or any of the other colors with my brush. And here I'm just softening out the edge where that blue didn't go completely into white, so I just added more water. I'm doing this on Canson XL paper, which will also be linked down in the doobly-doo down below. It's something I've switched almost entirely to now because it's really forgiving, and it does a really great job of allowing you to dab colors up, that kind of stuff, and it's really inexpensive. So I'll have a link in the doobly-doo so you can go check that out. The flag part here with the stars in it, I almost painted around each and every one, but I decided not to. So while it dried, all that area up there before I put my stars in with my white pen, I've added it to my card base, added my liner and all that sort of thing. And now I can take my Signo pen and do a little repair. Sorry, this went out of focus a little bit, but you can get the idea of what I'm doing. I'm just going to start filling in my stars. And since the stars are stamped there, you get the outer edge looks, you know, like little points of the stars in most of them. So all I have to do is put like a few dots of the white pen in there. I don't even have to draw little stars. And they still end up looking like stars, which is pretty cool. Kind of like when you can do those sort of little repairs and not have to get really super minute with the detail on them. But this is a good cheat for any time you're doing a flag and you need to add the detail. Do it later with a white pen instead. And now I can take any black pen, since I'm done with all the painting, I'm not going to add any more color, just using my Pentel pen to make the flagpole. And I'm adding the same dots that are in the stamp part, in the part up above. They have just little stippling dots, and I've just added them down. So it looks like it's all part of the stamp, even though it wasn't originally. So there is my card. I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope you will go hop along, see everybody else's creations, and be sure to click the links in the doobly-doo if you want to go see more of these supplies and check them all out. And I will talk to you guys later. Have a really great Memorial Day weekend, and we'll see you again next week on OWH TV. Thanks. Bye-bye.